got lots of mosquitoes here in Georgia. How lovely. So Mr. B and I, we just wanted to share the news about this. Make a video series on posture for musicians. I think there is, obviously, it's the only thing that's going to save me and get me back to playing fiddle. But I think a lot of people suffer from it, and I would like to help promote a culture of good posture. So let's go for a walk. A little choo-choo. A lot of musicians think that their lower arm pain is tendonitis, and a lot of times, as I myself have done mistakenly, it's actually due to a pinched nerve in the neck. Sometimes you don't even feel the pain in the neck. It's only in your arms. That's why it's very tricky to realize the root of the problem. But basically, most pain in the arms and the shoulder are treated the same way. You want good posture. I am going to make a series of videos about how to have better posture while you're living your regular life, because you can't have good posture as a musician unless you have good posture in regular life. So one way to get good posture in regular life is to make it part of your daily routine. Honestly, it helps to have pain because that reminds you when you're slouching forward. So forward head tilt, shoulders rounded forward, and weak lower abs and tight pecs. These things contribute to bad posture. I do a series of videos on how to do all those things to strengthen your ability to have muscle memory about your posture. So that means, like with music, when you train your fingers to do things for you without thinking, you want to train posture muscles to do things for you without thinking, so that you naturally want to pull back when you feel that you're aware that it doesn't feel good, what you're doing doesn't feel good. It is nothing that you do once a week and get. You have to make it part of your life. You have to make it a routine of keeping your chin in, shoulders together and down, your pecs open, and your lower back and abs strong. So you have to kind of make it a routine anytime you can. Like, okay, open up those pecs, stretch on things, like as soon as you wake up, to do something that opens up, and then also stretches out and down your traps. See, I actually stopped doing weights the last 2 weeks because they were just bulging too much and I was recruiting them too much. It's very common if you're a desk worker or a musician, you're gonna be using your traps too much, and they get overdeveloped just from that being over-recruited. Same for your subscapular muscle, which is involved in this kind of forward rotational thing. So you wanna do, I'm gonna make a bunch of videos how you really wanna do external rotation and opening up the chest to counteract that. So you do stretches to open the chest and to rotate the shoulders back. And then you do neck exercises to strengthen that posterior neck chain, and ab and lower back exercises. So all kinds of variations of snow angels. We're gonna go through that in detail and kind of talk through the common problems that people get, which is mostly has to do with recruiting your traps when you shouldn't. Good to get used to raising your arms and dropping the traps, but being aware of that. So whenever you're raising your arm to bow, you're aware of when your trap is up versus down. So many good things to learn, but they're not super sexy exercises, but they have to become part of your daily life. You can incorporate them into your walking routine, into your yoga, into your morning wake up before bed. And I'm also gonna do little videos about when you're in different places, how to be mindful of your posture. So like when you're cooking in the kitchen, chopping, how to periodically raise the head. If you're trying to avoid that more than 2 minutes in one forward head tilt, that just loads too much the front of your C5-6 spine, and they're gonna result in a pinched nerve if you don't also rupture the disc forward outside of its spinal column. In fact, it's helped me in previous years when I had flares of this pain, but now what's different is this pain lasted for 4 months, more than 4 months. So it really is, it's really bad. So I can't just do it. I couldn't do it on my own. I needed a proper physical therapist because what I was doing was I was kind of using bands in my arms in a way that overdeveloped my upper trap. It's a big problem. So now that I've worked with professionals, I want to share what I've learned. Man, it's hot out there. I mean, it's not so bad for August. It's not so bad for Atlanta in August compared to what other people say.
Mr. B says, I found it very nice, Mommy. I like the heat. I really do. You're not going to have that treat you were talking about?
It's time for the treat.